engineering, and I'm a third year music graduate. So when I came to know about this platform, I was in a dilemma. What would I speak about? Then I thought, what is expected here? We are supposed to use this platform to speak or express our views about both technical and non-technical aspects. So I thought, do we actually express what we feel? Or do we speak to impress others or to express our feelings? Do we speak to please others or to actually satisfy our conscience? And before judging anybody else, I decided to judge myself. And I was reminded of a situation in my life which actually changed my life tremendously. I have a younger brother who's in 7th grade. So he's really immature because he's the youngest one in my family. And today if he watches a movie on police officers, like to join police gang. Tomorrow he watches a movie on CBI officers, he wants to join CBI tomorrow. And the other tomorrow he watches a movie on IT personnel, he wants to be an IT engineer. It varies according to the movies he watches and the books he reads. However, when I was in 7th grade, I had this strong determination of only one ambition, and that was being an architect. This word architecture and this concept, I don't know where it got into my head, but I was crazy about it. That was the only ambition I had, that was the only thing I used to dream about. And every dream of mine involved me sitting in an MNC, working on structures and redesigning drawings, and every dream had this common factor called architecture. So I completed my 10th grade, and this craze grew to such a level that I couldn't neglect it at all, because I was that mad about architecture. And I took a very strong decision in my life in 10th grade to change my school to another school which provided a subject of engineering graphics. I knew graphics was drawing, architecture was drawing, so I thought this is going to get me closer to my dream. And the more I started drawing, I was crazy about it. I used to draw day and night, and I used to literally talk to my drafter, and I was mad about drawing. And this architecture dream grew stronger and stronger that I couldn't neglect it, and I had no other option as a career other than architecture because I was that mad about it. Then I finished my 12th grade examination. I gave my exam called ATHULYA, which is a qualifying examination for architecture. I qualified the exam and I decided to do it again for a better school. So the next time I went for my exam, it was in Kharkhund in Trivandrum. And I came out of the exam, I did pretty well. And I saw that my mother's face was really gloomy. So I asked her what's wrong, and she told me that your 12th grade CBSE marks are out. And I asked her, how is it? And she showed me the scorecard. I was stunned, astonished, flabbergasted, surprised, all those synonyms you have are mixed. Because I did really badly. I didn't expect such a score, I did that badly. And all those dreams I saw for the last 5 years, I could really see it in front of my eyes coming to a huge zero. And all I could do is helplessly stare. And I couldn't do anything because it was basically my fault, that's what I thought. And then, and there, I took the most stupidest decision of my life, which is to keep mum, to not speak for myself, to not express what my dream is, what my belief is. I decided to listen to everybody else other than myself. And so who's to be blamed? Me, myself. They told me civil engineering is related to architecture. I said, okay. They told me Sahrdaya College of Engineering Technology. I said, anywhere, it's fine. Now standing here as a third year B.Tech graduate, I'm proud of myself. I'm proud of this institution. I've learned a lot here. I've met so many beautiful people who have changed my life tremendously here. But beneath all this, still the term architecture that gives an immense pain in my heart. I have many friends who do architecture, and when I speak to them, I'm sure that day night I'll be crying to my sleep. Because it's a special pain, because that was my dream. And who was to be blamed because I couldn't pursue it? Me, myself. I didn't speak for myself. So my humble request to every person sitting here is, if you don't speak for yourself, nobody will. Because nobody cares. If you don't voice your opinion, nobody will. The people and the system depend on your side to put you where you are. If you want to grow, you need to speak for yourself. And we are obliged to leave the world a better place for the next generation. And if we don't start with ourselves, if we don't express our own opinions, then who will? Nobody will. So voice your opinions and be ready to face the consequences. At the end of the day, you're answerable only to God and your conscience. And if you can answer both of these factors, then there's nothing to be scared. So let me conclude by saying,